there's some really nice things. If we just did them, you know, big and put them on nice paper and stuff. So that's a great beginning. Okay, what I want to do is I just want to finish this up because we're running a little behind. And what I'm going to do these, I'm going to show you the same techniques that we're talking about using different media. A colored pencil. Okay. Here's two trees. There's the depiction of it. See, this one's on black paper. Okay, not. And this took all of 2 minutes. I mean, just. And then the ferns are just squiggles. Right, just squiggles. So, I'm not drawing a fern. I'm depicting what's there. Here's the state champion cherry bark oak. There's the state champion cherry bark oak. Okay.
Well, there's a sign off to the left.
It says, plus it's also 27 feet around. You can't miss it. It's 27 feet around. I mean, it's huge.
It's in the cache,
right. So you don't put everything, but you see the dark, the deep grooves, the dark lines, you know. Here's the one of those 1,500-year-old sculptures. Here's the depiction of it. Okay? This is a little bit more, but it's just layers and layers, and you just follow the contours. Okay. So it's just different. Do the same thing with watercolor. No, that's okay. We're not going to do it. That's okay. Here's three quick watercolor sketches of, okay, dark and light. Make all the big flaps, and then you simply put the shadows in, and all of a sudden you've got a shape or a kikri here, horizontal. It doesn't take long to do this, but just break it down into pieces that you can do, that you can mentally do. Okay, this is on your, okay, one more little thing here. Then we're going to go on a field trip. You are. Okay, once you've done a nice graphite drawing, and if you happen to have done it on watercolor paper, sketch, okay, and that adds another dimension. And these are all examples I'm going to show you are people from the cache. Okay, the cache were the most reluctant drawers I have ever seen. None of them. There were no hidden artists, no resident artists in the group. They all started from, they all came to learn photography. That's all they cared about. Okay. So, here's a lady's studies on a Katie did with her color, with her pencil. And then what did she do? She added just a watercolor wash. It's very light. Okay, that's all she did. And she's got this wonderful depiction of all the positions of a Katie did. Okay?
So the washes were wet, did you add color?
The washes were added later on, just as very transparent, very light.
The paper's wet.
This was a wet on wet technique. But you use graphite pencil because you know the water doesn't work with the graphite. Just very, very loose, you know. If you look really close at that, she didn't even stand the lines. Here's another one. I mean, the deer. Very quick, you know those quick sketches we did of the deer? If you add some wash to it, all of a sudden, you've got a depiction of, you know, dark light. But you can see everything through it. You can see everything, all the, that's the key, the watercolor washes. It's very light. Don't get crazy. I know it's one of the mistakes a lot of you make is you put stuff on the paper, it's too dark. Then you're done. Okay? Here's one. She had a really bad photo of a bird. She turned it into this really cute, nice depiction of a bird flying. The photo was, you know, not sharp.
We were giving them like two.
Here's one with flowers. She simply did the quick outline and just everywhere there was color, you just take the brush and just put the color in. Okay. These are washes. This lady absolutely. This is Karen Walsh, our most reluctant member of anything. I can't do anything. Yeah, you can. You know, she came back with this, and she says, you know, I did this. Because there was an ego mess, you know, and all this busy stuff, and all she did was start drawing vertical lines. And then she got all the vertical lines in, and she took a watercolor and just, she went up and down, you know, so you can see all the different kind of trees and the depiction and everything. And it's a very, very powerful depiction. When there's water, you know, she just didn't worry about it. But adding those two media together is very important. Here's one, same lady. She took a blurry photo of the eagle, and all she did was in trace the outline and put in just some hints. Looks like she knows what she's doing, right? I guarantee you, she doesn't.
Her favorite part of the class was the potluck.
She loved organizing.
She didn't even organize it, but she just came. No, she was like,
well, I'm using her as an example because she was the lowest common, absolutely the lowest common denominator in the class, and she rose up to do what we wanted her to do, okay? Simply by doing it. Here's another one of hers. See, she didn't even stay in the lines. If you've ever been in the cache in the summertime, there are no lines. It's hot, it's humid, it's hazy, it's foggy, it's fuzzy, and that's a perfect depiction of what it's like. And it certainly says bald cypress, you know. She didn't like using blue for some reason. I don't like blue. The water in the cache is certainly not blue.
Maybe she lost her blue.
She might have lost her blue paint. And then she did a beaver, swimming beaver. And she, remember those little techniques we said about cross-hatching? Okay, here's cross-hatching, you know. And she was getting, really, really, really good at it, okay? And I'm saying, if she can do it, I'm like, there's blue.
Yeah,
she did that little blue. If she can do it, you can do it, okay? All right. Okay, you guys are going on, turn up the lights, please. You guys are going on a field trip. And you can do it, we have between now and 1 o'clock to do the field trip and have your lunch. Okay, so you need to be back here at 1 o'clock. What you're going to do is there's a box of clipboards in the back, and you can do this one of two ways, or you can do it both ways. I don't care. Okay. One is we figured we've not taken advantage of Michael's museum very much here. Right? Instead of sitting in it and pee in it and all sorts of things. Not really taking advantage. So we've organized a museum field trip for you. Okay, and there are 7 activities that you have to do, and you have to fit each of those activities into one of these squares. Okay, we did this when we did it. We taught a workshop at the State Museum of Springfield, and worked that very well. So you have to look at these, and there's 7 and 9, so we gave you some leeway. Okay. We also gave you another one. Those of you that are very intrepid and want to go outside, if you can interpret this without having, if you can do it outside, there's a really nice prairie across the street. Where is it? Right there. It's got a lot of blooming stuff in it. It's just simply a 5-minute walk across the street. you wanna do that instead of doing the museum, if those of you that have been to the museum forever wanna go do that, if you can take this material here and interpret it into outside, it's another layer, because the stuff's not right in front of you. You can do the same activity across the street, okay, in the prairie. You simply walk across the road and walk down that little gravel road, maybe 10 feet, and then you can walk into the prairie. Okay, so you can do that also.
There's also paper, if you need to make some notes or whatever, you can take some of the paper that's under your paper towel.
Right. So basically, you're on your own for the 1 o'clock, and that's, remember, that includes lunch.
And this doesn't mean take a 2-hour lunch.
We'll expect to see something on your sheets when you come back, other than pizza stain or...
Oh, and then I forgot, Gail, did you want to show the newest merchandise thing?
Oh,
it's super cool.
And we just have these, they're just drink bottles, and they have the logo on them. So I have 4 or 5 of them if anybody wants one. They have $12. And there are a couple of them.
So you can do this with colored pencil, you can do it with whatever. You need to read it before you go out to make sure that you have everything with you that you need. If you don't know what some of this stuff is, then maybe we're paying attention. Okay, everybody.
Something that, this has nothing to do with that, but something several class members have asked is there going to be a field trip to some of the different sites around Emma Fine? Several people have asked, is there going to be a field trip to several of the sites around Emma Fine?
Okay, here's what the plan is. This class is for you to learn skills. Historically, what we then do is after the class, at the time, you know, we come back and we do a series of field experiences. What Sue and I thought would be most relevant for us and for you is that starting in September, we're going to be gone all of August. Sue and I will post, we'll either send an email out or post something and say, okay, Sue and I are going to be at Sandridge State Forest at the camp. That's different.
People want to know where some of the sites are here at Emma Fine if they're not familiar with them. They would like a field trip.
The main Emma Fine does that. In fact, we're meeting next Saturday. We have a meeting once a month, the third Saturday, from 9:30 to noon. And then sometimes we take field trips. And we don't have one planned next week. We're having a guest speaker, Narissa Michaels, is going to talk about the fish of Emma Fine.
Right.
The public's invited. All of you are invited, too. But the one after that, we're going to do a field trip for wildflowers. That'll be in August, third weekend in August. And Margaret Ovitz is going to lead that. She's
right. She's one of the other.
We're helping.
Yep. Okay. Is that what you want?
Mm-hmm. And I'll post this on Facebook.
Okay.
And you can mention the other layer.
All right, but never mind. Okay, so there are going to be opportunities for you to.
Several people are not from this area.
I know.
And they want
I'm not from this area.
Get the lay of the land.
Okay, the lay of the land.
So the point of the program is to
pass. You may get a little mock out. But if you're going outside, you can photograph something, that's fine. Or if you can photograph, if you want to photograph it in here, if you have the wherewithal, do it. Okay?
So, since we don't have our grids,
we have to. You didn't get handouts? So I gave them two. No, I'm giving you 4 grids. Sue, what did I do? What do I do with the pile of handouts? The museum adventure. We wouldn't want the museum director to miss out on the room. I'll give them 2 sets.
Oh.
All right, so you, like you said. All right, so you got it till 1 o'clock. Complete this, in the back, there are clipboards. If you wanna do it in colored pencil, take your colored pencil. If you wanna do it in watercolor, take your watercolor. You'll need your photo grid. You know that photo grid thing we gave you? If you don't know what the literary devices are.
It should be in their handout.
It's in your handout.
You'll forgive me for this, I hope. I'd like to use a literary device. It's called spelling. The name of this institution is D-I-C-K-S-O-N. We labor over this, with all deference to my close colleagues.
Okay, well, this amount is like 32 miles up the road.
It's like 2 hours up the road.
I also made a mistake on your. No, it's not, but. I also made a mistake, it says 12:30 to 1, it's actually.
One to two is right.
Oh, so after here, it's actually 1 to 2 from 6, so. It's been a hard